With you being a gynecologist and you kind of being new to the information as far as kind of recently doing the research and getting the information, how do you feel about other gynecologists and medical professionals that don't have this information, that, you know, women are being untreated or misdiagnosed? And second, I already know what you're going to say, but how do you feel about tampons?
Okay, let me answer the second one first, especially when we talked about physicians. Mm-hmm. When we went down to Bermuda and we did presentation down there, we had two women gynecologists, okay? And one woman, all that she wanted to hear is when it's Inspire going to have a tampon. And Mr. Iverson and I say, never. Okay, and we're in their country, so I respect, you know, I'm not gonna go down there and say to her, hey, you know, you're wrong. Obviously, she sold on tampons, which means she is not someone, okay, if she sold on it, who's gonna necessarily advocate, okay, her patients, okay, I mean, she may not, but she was sold on tampons. Okay, and so I'm against tampons. Now, you want to hear my little quick speech about that? Mm-hmm. Okay. The body is perfect. Every orifice of the body has a purpose. Every orifice, okay? Otherwise, God wouldn't put it there. Okay, it has a purpose, okay? The vagina basically is like a tube, okay? It's a conduit, it's a tunnel. It's allowing that which needs to leave the body and exit out, okay? So it's not like the blood has to think about, well, how do I get out of here? Hey, there it is. Go right through there, and you'll be out, okay? Same with the midi body, same with the rectum, okay? You have a bowel movement, because that is a waste product, and doesn't have to think about where to go. It goes out, okay? So, you have bacteria, I said earlier, in the vagina. It is supposed to be there. Bacteria and yeast live in symbiosis. They keep each other balanced, okay? They keep the pH at a certain level. And the reason the pH has to be at a certain level, because for impregnation, when that sperm goes into the vagina, it has to be in an environment that allows it to stay alive, to penetrate up through the cervix, into the uterus, out to the fallopian tubes, okay, to cause conception. So it's there for everything in the body is there for a reason, okay? All right, so now, when you put a tampon in the vagina, to me that's no different than sticking a plug up the rectum. Okay? I mean, you're stopping what is supposed to come out of it. Okay? You're delaying it. Okay, because obviously you take them out. But what have you done in delaying it? You've now allowed the bacteria that would have come out onto the pad and with the Cherish pad down under, okay, as opposed to sitting, okay, as the commercial ones do on the outside, you now have the bacteria, okay, and the blood is still coming. I mean, the tampon doesn't stop the blood from coming out of the uterus, okay? It just soaks up the blood, but it's in there. So the bacteria is just growing and growing and growing and growing, okay? And this is why women got toxic shock syndrome, okay? Because the bacteria built up, and then they had to go somewhere. And it was like, well, let's just go back through these walls, okay, of the vagina. And once it gets through the walls of the vagina, it gets into the bloodstream, and you are then toxic, okay? And that's, people die from that. Okay, but now, even those people who didn't die from it, okay, think about it, okay? Still, you sent bacteria into the bloodstream. And so that bacteria into the bloodstream, when you really think about it, that blood still passed through your liver, it passed through your heart, passed through your kidneys, okay? No, you didn't die of toxic shock syndrome, but you still poisoned your body, okay, with bacteria, okay? That, who knows, over an X number of years, okay? What, again, an irritant. The bacteria is an irritant, okay? So you sent that irritant through the heart, through the kidney, through the liver, okay, for all those years. And who knows, again, no one knows for sure, but you have to say to yourself, something that's irritating something, okay, it's not good. It's not it's supposed to come out, so why are you plugging it up? But the reason why women wore tampons is because these pads were ineffective. Okay, and their attitude was, yeah, I know tampons are not the healthiest, but I'm not having to carry this bag with me necessarily. I'm not feeling, I'm not so much looking to see did I soil or stain the seat on my clothes. So, yeah, it's like what it comes down to are the better of two evils. That's what it comes down to. Got evil bag, evil tampon, and the woman's like, okay, between the two, I'll take the evil tampon. Okay, so that's my answer about the tampons. Now, as far as positions, positions are funny. It's, and I guess because I've been one for over 40 years now, okay, they're funny. The only thing you can do is give them the knowledge, give them the information, okay? They have to synthesize it. They have to understand it. Just like when Vincent had me go to a presentation and I started caring about it, what did I do? Okay, I didn't boo-boo it, no. I just went to my own research, okay, and realized, okay, this makes sense. Wow, yeah, this makes sense. Wow, why hadn't these been in the United States sooner? That's how I looked at it. And then as a gynecologist now, remember, as a gynecologist, which is a little different than some of the other docs, I can then say to myself, wow, all those irritations, okay, all those ladies coming to me, you know, complaining of vaginal itching and burning and all these things, okay, now, okay, I have an added explanation of why it was happening. Because to be honest, no, I'm not going to say when a woman came to see me that I asked her how many pads do you use a day. I take that back. If she was coming in to ask me if I thought her cycles were abnormal, then of course I got to get some way of getting an idea of how much she's bleeding. But on a routine visit, no, I wasn't asking her how many pads you use every day. Okay, and what brand pads you use. Okay, no, I wasn't doing that. Okay, but I was dealing with the complaints that they were having. Okay, and again, one of the things that I talked about last time that I think needs to be emphasized, and I think it, when I say it, I feel good saying it because I'm a man, okay, is we have no idea of what a woman goes through. Okay, we have no clue what a woman. We gave a presentation at this church on 78 in Stone Mountain, and it was some high school young ladies from sophomore at high. And so I was talking to them, and I said, can you imagine a dad going up to his 13-year-old son and saying, son, just want to let you know, somewhere in the next couple months, gonna start bleeding through your penis. Okay, you're gonna be doing that every month, okay, until you're around 50, okay. You're gonna have cramping in your stomach, you may miss a day of school, you may have a little diarrhea, you're gonna feel miserable, okay. I said, and so they were laughing, and I said, think about that, okay. If I said that to you, you right now thinking, Yet women do that. They've done it, okay? And it's part of it, okay? So, to me, now I was talking about, like, after the cycle, and there's still that irritation. Okay, so you have this woman, okay? She wants to be intimate, okay? Obviously, she doesn't want to be intimate while she's on a cycle, all right? So that may be 4, 5, 6 days, all right? And what did I tell you? The first day or two after, she's probably still a little irritated, okay? So now, she may go through 6 to 9 days a month, okay, where she cannot be intimate with the person she wants to be intimate with, okay? Think about that, okay? Same dad telling his son, well, 6 to 9 days, son, you won't be able to have sex, and you won't want to have sex, okay? I mean, it's what women go through, men will never be able to comprehend. Never. Okay? So, one thing I like about this movement, I really like about the movement. It's a movement where men are involved, if nothing else, in the knowledge and the understanding, okay, of what our mates, okay, have been going through, what our mothers went through, what our grandmothers went through, okay? But we have the ability, the knowledge, okay, to maybe not have our daughters and our granddaughters go through what was obviously. So that's I hope I answered the question. Mm-hmm. Doctors, you just have to, they almost have to see it themselves, okay? Now, one way to do it, which is what I've done with a few doctors, is I don't talk to them about it from the standpoint of a doctor. I talk to them from the standpoint of them being a dad of a daughter. You see, now, because when you talk to a dad about his daughter, he will listen a whole lot more than when you talk to a dad about dad. Okay, so when I talk about